Welcome to the Seasoned Athlete Podcast, your home for stories, inspiration, and advice from athletes over 40. I'm your host, Robin Leggett. I'm a later in life athlete who became a roller derby skater in my 30s and a runner and obstacle racer in my 40s. Now I'm an athletic aging coach who helps women over 40 experience the massive life benefits that come with exploring your athletic potential at any age and any fitness background. If that fires you up, keep listening. Let's do this. I want to start this episode by telling a tale of two articles. I'm going to start with one that was published by the New York Times on January 20th. It was called The Benefits of Moderate Exercise. The article cited a study that sought to compare the metabolic benefits of standard 30-minute moderate workouts versus shorter bouts of high-intensity exercise. In this study, participants were split into two groups, one doing HIIT-style cycling workouts and the other pedaled at a pace that they could comfortably sustain. The results of the study showed that the moderate exercise group more effectively burned fat than the high-intensity interval training group. And so this was reported in one of the biggest media outlets in the world. So what is the problem here? Well, what I haven't yet revealed is that the study specifically recruited 32 sedentary, overweight men. First of all, this is a super small study, and results from a study this small can't be read as definitive. The article does make note of that, fair. But the other issue here is, where are the women? The article explains this too, although not in a way that's remotely satisfactory. The article states that they didn't use women for the study because of the concerns around menstrual cycles affecting metabolic results. To clarify, because women's hormonal levels change on a monthly basis for the greater part of our entire lives, apparently it is too inconvenient to study how different types of workouts might affect women differently than men. Instead, we get articles like this one that give blanket recommendations to everyone, even though it's quite possible and likely that training modalities can affect women differently. This is not new. Historically, studies around exercise and nutrition have primarily included mostly male participants, and yet the results are meant to apply to everyone. But to quote Dr. Stacy Sims, women are not small men, even if many of these fitness studies suggest that we are. As such, women need to take a more discerning eye to the information that's published that recommends how we should train. This leads me to the second article I want to talk about. This one was published by Spartan, and it caught my eye because I am a Spartan racer. I love Spartan racing, and I'm a certified Spartan coach. Like, I am entrenched in that life. So, of course, I was intrigued when I saw an article come through my email with the headline, "Should Women and Men Train Differently?" As I read it, I found my internal alarms going off at a couple points. First, the article said that as we age, men should add high-intensity interval training, but women can train as usual. Aside from this being contradictory to the New York Times article that came out a little later, which doesn't really matter because of the nature of the study, we already talked about that, the women's recommendation is just straight up incorrect. Why? Because the hormonal changes that women experience as we age accelerate the bone and muscle loss that already happens around aging. What I mean by this is estrogen typically plays a role in bone and muscle growth, but because we can't rely on estrogen to do that job as we age, we have to stimulate bone and muscle growth in different ways, primarily through lifting heavy weight and, yes, through high intensity interval training.
So, yes, women do need to make changes to training as we age.
Additionally, in a section of the Spartan article that discusses training and competing around our menstrual cycle, it says that women can indeed perform well during our period. Which is true, and I'll get to why in a second because the article doesn't get to that part. But then it goes on to say that women should train hard all the time because we can't control whether or not we'll have to compete on our period. Okay, what is wrong with this statement? Again, it doesn't get specific about why we perform well on our period or why we can perform well on our period. The article was quoting a CrossFit coach that was basically like this. "Hey, some of my athletes just happen to win competitions while on their periods, so don't be afraid of it, ladies." At least that's how I read it. But here's the real deal. When we are on our period, we are in what's called the follicular phase of our cycle. Estrogen drops during this phase, and our muscles have greater access to energy stores. As a result, we are better primed for high performance. As women, we are generally conditioned to think a little differently around our periods.
we actually want to shut down, right? That's how we feel. When you get your period, you're like, I don't want to do anything. I want to crawl in bed. I certainly don't want to compete in a race or anything like that. But in reality, this is the phase of our cycle where we have a greater ability for high performance. And ultimately, it does make sense for women to adjust our training based on the phases of our cycle. When we're in the high hormone phase in the weeks leading up to the period, we don't have as much of an ability to go hard, and we have a reduced ability to tap into our stored carbohydrates, since those are being reserved for a potential fertilized egg. It's a fancy way of saying the body wants to make a baby, and the period happens when the baby doesn't happen, right? But the body is still preparing for it, and that's why we can't tap into those stored carbohydrates. Ultimately, the more we can learn about our cycle and the hormonal fluctuations that come with it, the more nuance we can add to our training. So instead of an attitude of, well, look at that, I crushed it despite being on my period, which is the old school way of thinking, instead it can be more like, I crushed it because I know exactly what's going on in all phases of my cycle, and I adapt my training and nutrition accordingly. And that's really the crux of it. Women deserve education and knowledge around how to train, eat, and recover. But for the most part, that's not what we're seeing in the media or in the bulk of fitness and nutrition studies, which are still mostly being done with men. So what can we do to ensure we're not getting caught up in misinformation around these topics? First, don't believe everything you see in the media about exercise recommendations for women or for aging women. When you see these articles, keep an eye out for the following. First, how did they land on the information they're giving you? Are they citing a study? If so, what was the nature of the study and who were the participants? Who are they quoting? Is this a reputable source for women's physiology and fitness? Can you be sure of that? Next, find some online communities and groups that are specifically structured around midlife and aging women's fitness or midlife and aging women athletes. My Ageless Women Athletes group is one such group. We are all about helping women over 40 age like athletes, and I am specifically dedicated to sharing science-based information and education for women athletes at all stages. Finally, if you're a woman seeking to achieve bold athletic and fitness goals, does your fitness training and coaching reflect that? As we've seen, we have a long way to go to ensure women are getting the information, the knowledge, and training specific to our physiology at various stages of our lives. So it's not surprising that so many trainers, coaches, and fitness professionals just don't know this stuff. So if you want to make the most of your fitness training, find someone who does. The good news is there are people out there doing the work. I mentioned Dr. Stacy Sims earlier in this episode. Go follow her Instagram or read her book, Roar. I love that book. I cite it all the time. It is an amazing resource. There is a ton of great information in there. I'll give a shout out to the Hit Play Not Pause podcast. I had the creator, Celine Yeager, on this podcast. Hit Play Not Pause does a great job sharing information around training and nutrition for active and athletic women. And of course, I am here for you. I'm reading the articles and I'm busting the myths. We're also going to be digging deep on this topic in my Age Up Fitness membership community next month. April is Hack Your Hormones Month. So if this is a topic that lights you up and you're hungry for all the information on how you can train, eat, and recover in line with your hormones at all stages of your life, this is the time to join. Age Up is an immersive fitness experience empowering women over 40 to achieve bold athletic and fitness goals at any age. We provide done-for-you online fitness training to make it super easy for you to get effective workouts into your daily schedule. You get group coaching and one-on-one ongoing connection to a coach who is knowledgeable on topics around training midlife and aging women to live active lives. And you have an amazing community of women who are like you, they get you, and they'll support you in your unique fitness journey. Age Up gives you the workout BFFs from your local boutique gym and the custom support of a personal trainer, all from the comfort of your own home. And if you join by April 1st, you'll get to participate in Hack Your Hormones Month, which includes our brand new Hack Your Hormones course, where you'll learn about how to track and understand your cycle so that you can adjust how you train, eat, and recover to feel amazing, cross finish lines, and hit PRs like never before. We'll be discussing this topic weekly in our group and in our weekly Members Only Monday Huddle podcast and in our live coaching calls. This is how you level up your fitness like never before. If you want to join us for Hack Your Hormones Month in the Age Up membership, get on our waitlist now at robinleggett.com/waitlist.